Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to see how we can establish a simple communication link for our Arduino projects with these low-cost 433 MHz wireless modules. Without any further delay, let's get started. In this video, we are going to build a simple project just to demonstrate how easy it is to add wireless capability to our Arduino project with these 433 MHz modules. I have two Arduinos here. This one is sending the temperature and the humidity it measures every 2 seconds, and the other one is receiving the data and displaying it on the display. As you can see, this one-way communication is working fine and the range is good. We can easily get around 6 meters with a small antenna. The theoretical range that we can achieve is more than 100 meters. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. Please note, this video tutorial is prepared for Greece, where it is legal to operate low-power devices 10 mW in the 433 MHz band without a license. Check what's legal in your own country. This 433 MHz module is a low-cost wireless solution for Arduino. This module is the transmitter and this one is the receiver. We can only establish a one-way communication link using these two modules. The cost of both modules is less than $2. The kit operates at the 433 MHz band and it can achieve a data rate of 4 kilobits per second. The connection to Arduino is extremely easy. We only have to connect the data pin of the modules to a digital pin on Arduino. But let's now see how to build this project in detail. Let's first build the transmitter part of the project. At first, we connect the transmitter module and the DHT22 temperature and humidity sensor to a small breadboard. We connect VCC from both modules to the breadboard's positive rail and ground from both modules to the breadboard's ground rail. Next, we connect the data pin of the transmitter to digital pin 12 and the data pin of the DHT22 sensor to digital pin 4. Now, all we have to do is to connect the 5V output of the Arduino to the positive rail of the breadboard and the ground of the Arduino to the ground of the breadboard. That's it, the transmitter is ready. Let's now build the receiver. We connect again VCC and ground to the breadboard and we connect the data pin of the receiver to digital pin 12. In order to see how to connect the display, check out the detailed tutorial I have prepared a few weeks ago. Next, we connect the breadboard VCC to Arduino 5V and the breadboard ground to Arduino ground. Now we are ready to power up both ports. As you can see, the communication is working fine. The range we get without any antenna attached to the modules is a few centimeters. If we solder a small antenna like this one, we get a better range, about 5 to 6 meters. Now let's go to the computer to see the software side of the project. First of all, we have to download the virtual wire library in order to make our life easier when we work with the 433 MHz wireless modules. You can find the link for the library in the description of the video. Let's first see the transmitter code. It sends out a simple data structure which contains two floats, the temperature and the humidity. In order to establish a communication link, we have to set which pin we have connected the module to and set the communication bitrate. In this example, I have set the bitrate to 500 bits per second. Next, we read the temperature and the humidity from the sensor. We save the values in the data structure and with this line of code here, we send the data structure. It's that easy. Let's now see the receiver code. Again, we declare the same data structure. We initialize the receiver module with the same settings as the transmitter and we wait for data. If there is data available, we save that data in the data structure and then we print that data on the display. It's that easy. You can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, connecting these 433 MHz modules with Arduino is very easy. It is the easiest way to add wireless capabilities to your Arduino projects. Also, the price is extremely low. Unfortunately, there is a big disadvantage. The range of these modules is not great. Without an antenna, we won't get more than a meter of range. With this antenna, you are going to get some meters, but only if there are no obstacles between the modules. With a better antenna, I have read that we can achieve a range of around 100 meters. I haven't tested it so far, but I will soon. I will post a separate video on the antenna design and the range if I achieve to get a range of over 10 meters with obstacles. I would love to hear your experience with these modules. Have you managed to achieve a good range with these cheap modules? Please post your comments in the comment section below. Thank you. If you are new to the channel, you may not know that my day job is developing Android games, and 4 months ago I published a new game on Google Play Store. It is called Quiz of Knowledge and it is a quiz game that supports 5 languages and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, I am sure you are going to enjoy this one. If you wish, you can download it by clicking here or in a link in the description of the video. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.